Now, the political climate in Uganda is an interesting one and has been this week. Wainarua and incidents there got us to a trending hashtag, #Arua. Honorable Robert Kyagulanyi, General Mugisha Muntu, President Yoweri Museveni, Colonel Dr. Kizza Besigye were in the same place campaigning for their candidates. And of course, it came down to two people, that is Tiperu Nusra and the MP-elect now, Kassiano Wadri. It's been an interesting race. And on Wednesday, I think, if I'm not mistaken, on Wednesday evening, we had a loss of Robert Chagulanyi's driver, and that is Yasin Kauma. It was a very bad, sad incident for us, and it's a conversation that has led to a series of events here and there, up to arresting Kassiano Wadri, Robert Chagulanyi, and a number of MPs that had come through to Arua for these campaigns. Anyway, let me just not explain the whole thing to you. You've been seeing it online. Tweets have been coming through, Facebook posts and the like. Let me have the team here. This is Arthur Totally, Sassy Marvin, and Eric Mugisha as usual. Let's dissect into this thing and, of course, talk about some other trends, including the Twitter purge again. And, of course, you know, why are you shaking your head? Arthur, did you get your account back?
Yeah. I'm no longer Arthur Totally on Twitter. I'm Arthur Totally on Instagram. But now on Twitter, I'm called Digito Didan. The Twitter badge has become serious. Right, Jack was warning us of, as reading a thread that he's coming again for accounts that were suspended, that he's going to suspend them again, look for them and suspend them again. So you have to somehow hide. So I'm glad I had a third name. So I just added on Digito.
Hey.
And up to now, they've not yet caught me.
Sassy, what does this mean for, especially Uganda, now that we are politically heated up and, you know, accounts are being suspended left, right and center? Does this mean that, you know, and Robert keeps saying that 21st century problems or 21st century solutions, so Twitter is one of our solutions, we go there, make noise. What does this purge mean for Uganda's political atmosphere?
Whichever way you look at it, the recent purge by Twitter of accounts, which it claims to either be fake or bot, is going to negatively affect political discussions, especially on Twitter. You'll find that many of the people who have been leading conversations, starting conversations, like my friend here, Arthur, is now no longer in charge of his account. And from what he's saying, is even the one he currently has at the moment is also going to be taken away. So it's going to have a chilling effect. People are going to start fearing to come to Twitter and, you know, have these conversations, because they don't know what, if I say something, I don't know whether Twitter is going to take it to be sexist or whatever it is. So it's going to have a chilling effect, and people are going to pull away from the platform and maybe come back to the more liberal Facebook and other social media sites.
Now, Eric, let me come to you. Let me first read for you this post by Zawed De Viola. She says, Bobi Wine is going through what it takes to be a Besigye. This hustle is real, a hustle of life and death, but still a section of public doesn't trust his cause. What a shame. My heart is bleeding. Rest in peace. Yasin Wafe. Do you think that Bobi Wine is going through what Besigye went through probably in 2001?
If the person that made that post thinks Bobi Wine is going through what Besigye went through, they should know that if that's the trend Bobi Wine is taking, he's yet to meet 1%. He has only started saying it.
Wouldn't you give him 30%? Nah. Besigye was the time Besigye was being looked for. We had a story of Besigye crossing the border in a Gomesi. We had, you know, Bobi Wine was arrested from a ceiling. Isn't that something that's closed? And isn't it from the same script?
It's from the same script, because the writer is the same. I hope you get what I mean here.
No, I don't get. Who's the writer?
The government is still the same. Is still the same house ruling. So, but you remember Besigye had these allegations of raping a maid, then apparently affecting the said maid with HIV, which was all rumors. And then, because we didn't have these other measures of expression besides radio and TV, we didn't have too much social media like we have today, then such a rumor would go deep. Even people in the village would be like, but how do we start voting for a president that is sick? What if he dies in the chair? all those negative things that came up. So Bobi Wine is only meeting the bare 1%. And if he's to go through what Besigye went through during then, I think he should brace himself for more.
So you give him like 15 years. Stacey, let me come to you. The person that broke the story that, you know, has changed the conversation on Twitter is Bobi Wine himself. He tweeted and said that my driver has been shot dead by police and they thought they had killed me. Is that alarmist? Is that trying to incite the public? Is that fair, first of all, for you know, a tweet from someone like Bobi Wine?
Well, first and foremost, the tweet was not alarmist in any way. In any case, it was stating a fact. His driver had been shot. And from what he says, what his family members have been saying, the driver was shot in the same place that Bobi Wine usually sits at when he's inside the car. So for him to come and say that they have shot my driver dead, but I suspect they wanted to shoot me because that's what I usually... I don't think that's alarmist.
He accused the police of wanting to shoot him. Is that fair, Arthur?
To be honest, I wasn't in Arua by then, so I can't start deceiving. I can't start deceiving on national TV. But I like the tweets that were coming through. That tweet actually somehow broke my heart. Even the engagement it was getting was serious. Literally, it blew up to the rest of East Africa in just 30 minutes. Kenyans were already talking about it and stuff. But the interesting part, you know, every bad thing has a humorous side. Well, these guys who are talking about the stone. People were saying that the rock, the stone that hit the bulletproof car, was the one that hit Goliath. they started drawing anatomies of the of the stone that it had a deflector of stray bullets from Bobi Wine's car. It had glass debris absorbers. It had bulletproof dictators. It had stone hoods. It was just crazy. That was the only serious part. Otherwise, the MPs are going to face serious consequences. I've already heard that Wadiri, is it Kassiano Wadiri, is already facing treason. We are waiting for what will happen to Bobi Wine. So it's a very serious offense, and treason is not something you joke with.
See what happens here. This is how I see it. I see the state using all its mechanism to kind of control the public. Not govern, but control. It's trying to limit the spaces these people are supposed to get into. If they realize Kassiano is actually going to get elected, NRM knew even before election that this wasn't really their stronghold. They knew they couldn't win it. So if you realize they can come up with these many charges and kind of limit Bobi Wine's movements, kind of limit Kassiano Wadri and the beating that happened to Zake Francis and all these other politicians whose state is yet to be known to us. Yesterday, Kadaga authorized MPs to go to Gulu and find, because when they reported about Bobi Wine, there were no images. They said he's in a bad state. But like that's all Moses Ali gave the nation, like Bobi Wine is in a bad state, and he said that confidently, like that was a usual thing to say on TV. So I don't know where we are heading, by the way.
You don't know where we're heading. Let me
I don't
you, Sassy. Eric talks about the state controlling, but then the first tweet that came through to clarify why, to sort of shed light on why Yasin was shot dead, was from Don Wanyama. He comes through with a picture of one of the presidential cars and says it was stoned. And later, security agencies came through, swept, and sadly, we lost someone. Is that the state controlling, or is that the state giving us, the people, time to, you know, sieve the story, and then later they'll come and clarify?
Well, the state is... definitely what Don Wanyama succeeded at was to spin this story, because the state had to come up with an explanation for the death of Bobi Wine's driver, who was, one, not at the scene of Museveni's rally, two, not at the scene of the said processions, in town, and three who was like more than 2 kilometers away from where the presidential convoy was. So you remember that after Bobi Wine comes out and says his driver has been shot dead, and the question on everyone's lips is how, what has he done, what was happening? And then Don Wanyama comes up and does his usual job of spinning the story, and he tweets or posts this picture of the president's car, you know, being hit with a Goliath's stone and things like that. You know, they are trying to give an explanation for a situation which otherwise has no logical explanation. This is a man who has been shot in a car parked somewhere, hundreds of miles away from where the presidential convoy was.
When he was shot at the time, when the convoy was actually stoned.
Yes.
The president's convoy was stoned at around 6:30. Bob Wine's driver was
shot at
around 7. 30 minutes difference. And then that is because you can't relate that.
Maybe
to
this is
scenarios.
Let's head in for a short break. And when we get back, we are still talking about what happened in Arua. We're trying to make sense of it. The stone, the presidential car, Yasin Lubowa, the guns, you know, found in the hotels, Bobi Wine in the ceiling. There's lots of dimension to this story, but let's head into a short break and get back to this.